Dumbest Sports Talk Worldwide, which news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now we're going to stay on there next. We're going to talk about it every time something happens with our three undefeated heavyweight champions. We're talking to Anthony Joshua, Deontay Wilder, and Joseph Parker. Three undefeated heavyweight champions. We talk about them pretty much every day now that something happens. Well, the promoter of Anthony Joshua tells Joseph Parker, hey, if Anthony Joshua got a glass jaw, then come get some. Let's prove it, basically, right? And so this stems from Joseph Parker's team being active, and they called like a little press conference and showed that a few people who said they've floored Anthony Joshua. And they wanted to show people, and they offered people 20,000 pounds or whatever it is to find footage of Joseph Parker being dropped. What they were trying to put on display is Anthony Joshua's jaw is glass, and, you know, Joseph Parker's jaw is granite. So this has apparently irked Anthony Joshua and Eddie Hearn, his promoter, and they seem to be getting closer and closer. Eddie Hearn says they're single digits away in terms of negotiation, you know, single digits. And so it's less than 10% difference of what these guys are close to their negotiation point, to the point where they're saying, okay, we can do this. So, you know, Eddie Hearn's just telling Joseph Parker, look, man, you're going to get to multiple, your biggest payday by multiple times, right? And come over here to England and join the party, right? This is cool, but you still don't want to lowball Joseph Parker. It's still going to be hard for a guy to get the same percentage as a mandatory challenger when he's a heavyweight champion. That's just going to be a hard thing to swallow no matter what you get. Because at some times, you know how you get in negotiations, people around the world, you get in negotiations and the person who has the money, he asks you, it's your idea. You deserve more, but he'll ask you, well, what are you normally accustomed to? And just wants to give you more, a little bit more than what you're accustomed to, but it has nothing to do with how much you deserve. That's a part type, like entitlement. That's what that is. So what they're basically saying is, we don't care if you're champion. You've only made so and so much before, right? So you can make more than that, and you should be happy. Instead of, I'm a champion, we need each other, we're going to pay you because we want you and your belt. Somebody wrote in the comments section, what does Joseph Parker bring to the table other than a belt? Well, there's nothing other than a belt. That's the point. He brings a belt that these champions should want because they should want all of them. And only people that don't like all of this stuff are people like us that want unification, that want one champion. Because, and I told you guys before, all of these sanctioning bodies, because we have four sanctioning bodies, and we have another one trying to creep through the back door, the IBO, you know, in about 6 months, that's going to be respected. Then we're going to have five sanctioning bodies, which means we will possibly have five heavyweight champions. So when you get close to unification, well, we can say, hey, that's the heavyweight champion. You say that when somebody walks in the door, hey, here comes the heavyweight champion of the world, right? People thinking about 18 people could walk in the door with all these championships. It's not one. That's the point. So that's what we're trying to get at. So this seems to be good news in a way because the work of Joseph Parker and his team to get under the skin of Anthony Joshua, it seems to have worked. It seems that they're trying to get this fight going first, right? And that's good enough. At least it's some sort of unification. And if we're lucky, then soon, because like I told you before, we want to get this early in the year that we could possibly get unification towards the end or middle to end of next year, 2018. It would be nice. It's not that far away. So that's the news. Eddie Hearn and Anthony Joshua's irk. If we got a glass jaw, then come get it. Sounds good to me. Getting closer. Dumbest Sports Talk Worldwide. And I'm about to hear y'all.